Italy's prime minister is coming increasingly under fire for his alleged sex scandals, but there's a person who says it's all false. RT exclusively met with Raisa Skorkina, who claims to be a close friend of Berlusconi, and she says his parties are just about innocent dancing and singing. She claims it's the communists behind the media campaign against the embattled premier.
Just friends, but close ones. That's what Raisa Skorkina says of her relationship with Silvio Berlusconi, which she says is exceptionally warm and friendly. She's been a guest at his famed parties, which have landed him in rather hot water. Raisa told RT how this scandal changed her relationship with Italy's most powerful man.
Silvio and I are closer together than ever. Earlier, we were together like this, but now we're much, much closer together.
Raisa, how did you meet Silvio Berlusconi? What kind of impression did he make on you?
I can't even explain what I felt inside when I met him. He gave me goosebumps when I saw him, because he's a very handsome man. It was love at first sight. He's such a gentleman, 100% man in every sense.
How often do you see each other now? Tell us about your relationship.
For me, he's always been like a guardian angel, as he puts it himself. In my heart, my feelings for him sparkle, and he knows it. And this is going to stay forever. You should understand that even if I fall in love or marry, my husband might resent it, but Silvio will stay in my heart forever. I'm gonna cry now. Even if he has 15 free minutes, he says, Raya, come, and I come and we talk.
New witnesses in Berlusconi's case said that party guests behaved indecently, and they were also encouraged to take part in some kind of frivolous game. What can you tell us about Berlusconi's parties?
I once was at his New Year's party, and we all glided smoothly to the dance floor. There was a DJ, and we just started dancing. There were drinks and cool things floating around the place. And there were men, not only women, as the media says. Once he invited a special dance show, but it wasn't like anything outrageous. It was a beautiful Moulin Rouge-style show. He started singing, because he always sings very, very well, like Pavarotti. His voice is very powerful. He writes songs himself and then sings them. That's how it all starts. We eat and he starts singing or telling jokes. Then I took him by the hand, went to his office, discussed my business and I left. That's it.
Can you tell us about the presents that Mr. Berlusconi gave you?
Silvio gives presents to all women, not to men. He has special scarves, foulari, and he gives them to women, like a memento of visiting Berlusconi. It might be a pin or a ring, nothing expensive, or a scarf. Everything is made especially for him, so that he can give his own presents.
Who could benefit from this scandal? Do you think Berlusconi is being attacked by a special media campaign?
It's the communists. Of course it's them. Who else would benefit? They want to get rid of him as fast as possible, by any means. I don't know. They might even bring something from the moon and say that Berlusconi did something there. That's all we need right now.
Can you tell us more about the secret language that you're using with Silvio Berlusconi?
Around 2005, they started digging into my private business and tapping my phone to discredit Silvio. We understood the situation, and for example, if I was in trouble and I couldn't handle it myself, I asked him for help, and he immediately understood it and helped. Well, there are a couple of words, but I can't tell you, because if they tap me again, they'll understand everything.
Do you feel secure even though Berlusconi leaves in 2013?
I'll build my own destiny and we'll see each other and sit on the bench in his garden and laugh and tell jokes. You can't even imagine how much he loves Italy. Once he told me, Raya, I think I'll die working.